Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus. I've just started the Ultra Hard Challenge, and I gotta say, this is a doozy. I've had a few. Oh, Tech X. Nice. This is actually probably already doable. I've had a few starts with the Ultra Hard Challenge, and I've decided not to continue them. First of all, because I died like a minute or two in. It is really ultra hard. Sissy long legs, that's not too bad. But yeah, just take a look at. Ouch. Take a look at this. We don't see our map. We don't see our items. I mean, we don't see our health, but that's not always the case. And we need to go to Mega Satan. Isn't that lovely? Also, we are Isaac without the D6. Just putting that out there. Lovers? Well, yeah, another thing. The challenge does not allow for hearts to drop, as you can see just there. I would probably blow up that tinted rock. Oh yeah, and that's the worst thing. We don't see our map, but we still get teleported around with Curse of the Maze. I'm gonna try anyway. For small rock, we get a bomb back, so why not? But tinted rocks can't contain any soul hearts, as far as I know. So that's awesome, right? Yeah. I mean, it's okay. We got some HP here. That's very important. Because basically, our heart containers might as well be spirit hearts at this point, because we can't replenish them other than getting HP ups from the boss like this. But if we don't get any heart drops, then old bandage can never be filled up, right? And it can never spawn hearts at being hit either. So actually, that was a bad thing to pick up, but I didn't know, since it was a question mark. It could have been anything. Well, at least we got a really good offensive room clearing item in the form of Tech X. Might just be my favorite one of the non-tier related items. So far so good, I'd say. We can stay at a relative distance and clear everybody out. And do the, oh shit. Do the bubble wrap thing. The low enemies and the dips. Also, pretty much all the enemies seem to be champions, right? So most of their attacks will deal a full heart of damage, amazingly. Shit! He's tanky. Okay. I guess we might as well go to the boss, right? Double W Juniors. Well, it's not gonna stand up against Tech X, I'm gonna tell you that much. Coat Hanger is nice. Okay. I wanna see if maybe we can get some HP from this guy. HP upgrade would be very nice. Yeah! Okay, that was very lucky, but I'll take it. I wonder if a Two of Hearts pill, Two of Hearts card would work. What I do want to do, because this is Curse's Labyrinth, obviously, is go to both item rooms, if I can. We haven't been to either of them. Oh dear. Well, at least it's Red House. Alright. Oh, we got both item rooms in here. We'll see what this lost cork is. I still don't know. Oh, come on. At least he wasn't far away. Cricket's body. Gives us a tears up, but I don't think it changes Tech X at all. Yo, listen! Now, this item, I had it a few times before, I think. At least once. What it does is, as you can see here, it shows you secrets on the map. And this is awesome. Small rock. Thank you, Lavi. It shows you secrets such as tinted rocks, but also like secret rooms. Which is going to be cool because we can't see our map and we couldn't really extrapolate that well from the map layout. So yeah, very nice. Oh yeah, see? Here's a secret room entrance, probably. Uh-huh. Yeah, it doesn't look at first like it does anything, but if you actually listen to it, it gives you some sort of benefit. Okay. Teleport again into a very tricky room. Health down! I mean, it's not that bad since we wouldn't have been able to benefit from it anyway. So it's actually, yeah. It's actually, oh. Yeah, we've been here before. Damn it, Navi. Guess that's the trouble with Navi, but I might as well blow this up.
Explosive.
Okay. Could have known about that pill earlier. And two more. Bombs actually become very good. But Balls of Steel is awesome. It's basically a 2 HP up. It's basically raw liver for all intents and purposes of this challenge. Honestly, I kinda dig it. As weird as it sounds. Cause it's like, you know, this is the best the game can throw at you, and if you can survive it long enough, and if you can play good enough, then you can persevere. Yeah. And Monster and Fistula? You're getting all the rare double trouble bosses. Obviously, you kill Monstro first. Okay, that was easy enough. And more HP, which I'm actually very thankful for. Oh, man. Yeah, this is pretty much definitely the best ultra hard run I've ever had. Like, the first two or three or something, they got me to like the cave floors and no further. Don't think I've seen one on the depths before. Might be wrong, but oh no, just boss steal, that's so good. Keep him coming, boys. Okay. Right. The only thing that does piss me off is the curses. Okay. So far, I'm actually quite proud of my play. Oh, careful, careful, careful. Now what I would like, actually, is a teleport card so I can go to boss rush without having to fight it. Although, I guess on boss rush, all I would be able to get is one mystery item, so it's basically just one extra item room, right? Usually the appeal of boss rush is that you get your choice out of four items, but if you don't know which item is which, then, you know, it doesn't really matter. Yeah, I'll go in here. There's no real reason to do anything else with your bombs. Oh, also, no donation machine either. Although I guess that's the worst of, that's the least of my problems. I haven't seen people beat this challenge yet, although, okay, they have it. Fine by me. But I've heard people complaining about it. So I don't know how long it usually takes people. There was one challenge in Afterbirth that was similarly difficult, in my opinion, which is the speed challenge, which you really had to be like... You had to have a really, really awesome run to actually beat it. And this seems to be similar. Let's see. I hope this is the right way. Whoa. Would actually also be really cool if, you know, on a Curse of the Lost, Navi would show you the way to the boss fight. That would be cool. Of course, the white enemy will not die unless all the other enemies are dead. Very dangerous, but we made it through. No cards so far. Jesus. So many big rooms too. Whoa! Invisible dude. Calm down. Whenever I'm on a Curse of the Blind, I always go, okay. Might as well have a look in there. Okay, this could be nice. And it's the Joker. So yeah, we would get an item out of Boss Rush. If we actually can make it there. We have 7 minutes left, so I'm quite hopeful of that. Unless we keep getting teleported around. Honestly, I'm quite impressed. Like, I haven't been taking any useless damage in quite a while. You know what? I actually wanna get my Joker card out of the way early, Book of Sin, and nothing, and Dark Matter. Because we're almost guaranteed to get more cards here. We got 14 bombs and more than 6 minutes to go. Doesn't Just gotta. Oh, there we go. Honestly, was quite disoriented there. Yeah, please blow the lever. Well, only one. Come on, dude. Well, at least now we can use the battery charges, although whenever Book of Sin pays out with a heart, it's just not gonna do anything, huh? It could at least have given me, like, a different payout, you know? I wanna find my way here. It's the most pivotal thing. Oh, I thought that guy would have been exploding. Guess I thought wrong. Ah. Another helpful tip by Navi. It turns out to be nothing. That would usually have a black heart in it, but not this time. Nothing, really. Ah, no. Well, we fought our boss fights at least. It's, I can see forever? Well, it's gonna save me another bomb, but nothing more than that. Oh, there we are! I knew there had to be somewhere. Okay. Thanks for that. Friendly ball. No, thank you. And crack the sky. Huh. I think I'll take that, honestly. Crack the sky has been severely buffed in Afterbirth. I think it didn't used to be buffed even at the beginning of Afterbirth, but it got like a post-launch patch where they just made it so the beams would actually home in on enemies, you know? More skulls. I'd like to blow up a few at a time, if possible. Oh, this could be good. Or not. Of course, no spirit hearts from chests. What a piss off. Honestly, if you're looking at this run right now, and you think, well, it's not that hard, right? Keep in mind, Tech X by itself is kind of like a game-winning item sometimes. And it definitely is in here, like, chariot. But, it has pretty high damage. It has, piercing effect. And yeah, I think it's just very overpowered. The more overpowered, the earlier you get it in a run. So might as well do that too. Getting low on time now though, and we're running out of skulls. Yeah, these other few runs that I had. Ooh, okay, can at least try here. Magician would be good if I could. I would actually take Telepathy for Dummies instead of Crack the Sky if I had the chance. Now please stop teleporting me. It's getting a little ridiculous. Yeah, it came from that. Come on! I think it's this way. Yeah, this looks familiar. No. This way? No? Oh god. It's that shit again. Curse of the Maze won't just teleport you around, it would also teleport rooms around, so it will swap them. So even though you know this room is at this point on the floor, it might just get teleported to a different room. Okay, we know the boss. Come on! Yeah, from here, the boss should be down and to the left. You motherfucker. Remember when I said 7 minutes? Oh, that's the boss fight. Oh, never mind. Oh, come on! Remember when I said 7 minutes would be more than enough? Think again. It's double wretched. Well, they should die pretty fast. And then all we need to go to is mom. White Rage is good, though. Of course, we can't teleport out, so... Boss Rush is meaningless. Because I sure as hell won't be fighting anything in here. But I don't have to. Well, we won't ever actually get to see Boss Rush either. Oh, that was just stupid. That last hit. I did so well. Oh well, okay. So we got 5 HP to go through this. Yeah, let's just teleport out. Might as well, right? We don't know where we're going anyway. But we did leave behind a strength card, which is effectively an HP upgrade for one boss fight. And there it is. Okay. Okay! Got a tinted rock over there, but I don't think we need to check any more tinted rocks. Although I'd like to, if they had HP, because you already have small rocks, so there's not much else we could hope for there. That's a little bit of a tricky wall hugger room. This balls of steel could actually save my life. Okay, good thing it. Oh, damn. Oh, God. Good thing I saved my pills. I'm keeping Balls of Steel and not using it right now, simply because, who knows, maybe I, just on the off chance that I get a little baggy. God damn it. This teleporting shit. Okay, where the hell am I? I'm so lost. Maybe this way? Yeah, okay. Back on track, it seems. Although, maybe I just jinxed myself. Yeah. We're not really using Rack the Sky, so I was like, yeah, may as well. This could be awesome, though. Could you imagine blank card the gaz? Okay, guess we don't get the gaz, but get two balls of steel pills! Probably the best use of Yera I've ever done. Might as well. Yeah, it's nothing. Okay. There's always a chance of a golden chest, obviously. Gluttony goes down easily and doesn't drop anything, of course. Wait, what? You got teleported all across the whole thing. Okay. At least this room you haven't seen before. I just saw my starting room again. That much I know. Okay. Oh dear. Well, that worked. Fear does help out sometimes. Let's see, maybe... I know what I'm hoping for. Dry baby? That would be awesome, but no such luck. I think you do need a lot of luck for this challenge. So... Womb XL, huh? Takes a long freaking time. I mean, if you can't see your... if you can't see your map, everything kind of seems a lot longer and harder than you think. Than it actually is. Okay. That was close. Basically, do not stand still at the beginning of this room. Although, the Gertie Jr. itself was pretty chill. As is Monstro, because he's dead. Don't really know why I'm picking all this up. Okay, where the hell am I again? Should be the tagline here. Okay. All right. That is a dead end. Where the hell am I? And once again. Okay, this is the starting room again. This one. So... Okay. I literally have no idea
what's going on. I mean, I do remember the room layout somewhat, but... Come on. I need to... What the fuck? I need to get, at least at the end of some of the paths that actually have some progress attached to it. Oh god. Because I think what happens with Curse of the Maze is that it only teleports you a few rooms away, ever. And if I keep getting, you know, teleported around in the same sort of general area, I'll never get away, basically. I'll always be stuck where I am. Never make any progress. But dude... Fuck! No. think I ran past the spawning room again. Oh my god, I know this again. This is a dead end, yes. Okay. I thought so, but I have to check again, because I'm starting to distrust my senses. No. Oh my god. I don't know what the game is trying to tell me here. It can't be, you know, right down the floor layout on a map somewhere in front of you. Because the rooms are starting to teleport as well, so I can never really be sure of where I am. This is so fucked. We've been through all these rooms so many different times. God. You fucking bitch! You bitch! I hate the challenge so much right now. Like, this is ultra hard, right? What is hard about this? Is it, you know, trying to grind me down? Is it trying to break my will? Then my follow-up question is, how is it fun? The game's supposed to be fun. Move my mind here. Is there a boss in this floor? Like, I could be mistaken, but maybe this challenge is not supposed to be completed. And it's a huge troll. In the end, the game comes out and tells you, well, look, we had a lot of fun here, but you know what you're getting out. So just lay down the controller and start this run. How about that? But I don't go out like that, okay? Fucking bitch. That fucking nickel is so... It's taunting me. You've been here before, and I will remind you of that every time you walk into the room. I'm a monument to your own inability to make any sort of progress. Shouldn't it now have teleported me to a room that's closer to progress just by sheer luck? This is unbelievable! Maybe I should just enter and exit out of rooms and try to find new rooms I haven't seen yet, or not haven't seen as much. This room again, like...
Oh my god, really?! Finally. Now please don't teleport me again, alright? Please don't. Okay, I guess this was the path that's been preordained for us to actually beat this. Yeah, this is completely new. Like, we haven't been able to go this way at all. Not even close. Oh, finally. Oh, boy. This was the worst, guys. Truly. Okay, Blastocyst can be trouble if you don't focus on one at a time. Thank you for the HP, at least. Alright, Mom. Roll over and die if you can manage that. Now, please, don't let this happen again on the next floor. I don't know if I could take that. But even if it does, we won't have to do it again on the next one. Specifically since we can just go to a Mega Satan fight right away. This fundamental flaw. First of all, who thought that was fun? Having Curse of the Lost and Curse of the Maze at the same time. But secondly, I mean, it could be okay. But on a room, on a floor like the Womb XL, with so many fucking rooms on it, it just becomes unplayable almost. Right? Yeah, might as well. Yeah. Thanks, Navi. You're the best. That was very close. Okay. Health up. Okay. Well, it's gonna take up some space. For sure. But honestly, we're really, really, we're looking very good on this run. In terms of Mega Satan, it might be tough. It depends, of course, on the items that we still need to get on the chest, but I hope there's items on the chest. Believe me. If there's no items on the chest, that'll be a different story, but yeah. From an HP standpoint, we could be looking a lot worse. And that's almost the entirety of what I'm basing this run around right now. Can I maintain my HP? I don't think... Fuck! Should have trusted my gut there. X-Lax again. And this was slightly scary. But it worked. Maybe we can X-Lax some enemies in there. No? Okay. I'll try again. I know what it does for me. It does make me slip around, but maybe it does as well with the enemies. Of course. No HP for you, buddy. Just remember that. Secret room over here. Thank you, Navi. Okay. Well, we'll get there, I hope. Navi also points out the... What? No! No, you wouldn't! No, come on! This is... I shouldn't have fucking counted my chickens, man! This is awful. This is the worst thing that could have happened to me. If you didn't know... Cursed Eye... I don't think it actually benefits me. Because usually it shoots out 4 tiers, but... I'm still charging my shots, so I'm thinking... The other effect still applies, which means whenever I get hit or take any damage during the charge up, I get teleported. Okay? Don't fuck me again, Navi. Great. Fantastic. Whenever I get hit, I get teleported. Well, I mean, as long as I'm charging. Which means... unless I'm in, like, completely the luckiest Isaac player alive. The sun is so good, though. Ooh, we gotta take the sun. This would be... Okay. If it teleports me during the Mega Satan fight, I'll have to do it all over again. From the beginning. Oh, shit. No, I didn't know why I didn't get teleported when I took some damage against the keeper enemies there on the last room, but I don't know. I could be wrong, because usually, like I said, you get 4 tiers out of it, and we still have that one laser. So maybe we're lucky, and the cursed eye effect doesn't apply. But I don't know. I couldn't tell you. And the fucking sun is the cherry on the shit sundae, since without Cursed Eye, the sun would have guaranteed our victory. Freaking guaranteed it. Spoonbender. Ooh. Little Gish. Ipecac. Well, as far as I know, Ipecac won't hurt us. It just gives us a huge damage increase. So, here we go. Mega Satan. Spoonbender is really going to rock the show, but I got to be so fucking... careful here not to get hit while charging, because boy, I do not want to do this fight twice, or three times, or four times. Honestly, like the third time at most, I would probably die. Okay, we're still not strong enough to actually skip any phases of him, so don't get too close to me. Oh god, I'm boxed in. Okay, at least I managed my charge time there. Fuck. This is getting dicey. Only 4 XP, HP more, which is actually 7. Ah. Okay, we've been hit enough times that I'm actually thinking Cursed Eye is not working here. To my extreme relief. So I think this should work. Actually, it's more than 7 HP. What am I talking about? It's 9 HP. Because we can use the sun while at 1 HP and then heal fully. Kinda confused with 2 of hearts. Excuse my confusion. There was no way I wasn't gonna get hit there. How am I slowing him down? Oh, it's Gish. Right. And we did it! Holy fuck! Okay. Wow. Oh, God. Dare I touch it? I dare. Oh, Samson feels healthy. Thank you for watching. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'll go and have a heart attack. Bye-bye.